So let us come back and see 2008 paper. So what did they give us? Here they've given you name the reagents which are used in the following conversions, right? I have to just basically write the reagents, nothing to show with the mechanism, nothing to show with the reaction, but better you write the reactant and the product and write the reagent above. So now what did they give me? Primary alcohol to aldehydes. So whenever you see such type of questions, let us have one hint in a hint. Let us recollect that we very well know primary alcohols. Let me write this as a hint so that it'll be useful. Great. Yeah, primary alcohols on oxidation gives us your aldehydes. Correct. Aldehydes further get oxidized to acids. So no. Then we said secondary alcohols on oxidation gives us ketones. Correct. So ketones, they resist further oxidation unless until you give or provide vigorous conditions to that particular reaction. Yes. And tertiary alcohols, I already said oxidation very, very difficult, because unless until you, I have already shown this again, vigorous conditions, then only it, or it normally at normal temperature it resists oxidation. Now what did they give me? Primary alcohol. So they've not given any type of this one, so you can just directly write primary alcohol. Okay, not a problem, right? You could just mention it with like this general formula, H, this is your primary alcohol. Now they have to get converted to aldehyde RCHO. Now what is the best reagent for converting primary alcohol to aldehyde is your chromium based reagents, right? Just remember, primary alcohols to aldehydes, I can use best oxidizing agents like chromium peroxide in the presence of pyridine. What is this reagent? Collins reagent. This is your Collins reagent. Right, so chromium based, this one, even your PCC, peridinium chlorochromate, your partial oxidation, you can use that also. So chromium in the presence of peroxide is the best oxidizing agent, simple to convert alcohol to aldehyde. Correct. Now they've given me butanone to butanol. Yes, butanone to butanol I have to use. Just say write the structure. Here they've not given the structure, I've not written anything, but here they've given me a structure. So butanone. Okay, 2-butanone, right? 2-butanol they said. 1, 2. So which butanol they gave me? They've given me 2-butanol, right? Now this is your CH3, this is your CH3, H2 and your H. This is your 2-butanol. Now this is your butane 2-one. Butane 1, 2, 3-one. Done. Now observe carefully, what is the difference between both? Here in this particular compound, this is a ketone and this is an alcohol. Yeah, what did you add? You added one hydrogen here and one hydrogen here. Yes. So what is addition of hydrogen? Addition of hydrogen is reduction, which is the reduction process. For reduction process to happen, you require a reducing agent. Yes. So we have already listed out reducing agents, like, we have already given list of reducing agents like lithium aluminium hydride, sodium borohydride, correct, nickel, platinum. Yeah. So we have already given your this in metal, metals also act as reducing agents. So here if I say for ketone to get converted into your secondary alcohol, the best reducing agent is sodium borohydride. Lithium also is fine, but sodium borohydride is specific, because in your board key they'll give you specific answers in the marking scheme. So sodium borohydride, what is it going to do? It's going to add 2 hydrogens, one above here, one here, so you get a secondary alcohol. So try to prefer this for as a reducing agent, because it has to add hydrogen. So next, phenol to 2,4,6 tribromophenol, a picric acid. So they have said your phenol to 2,4,6 tribromophenol. This also we have done, 2,4,6 tribromophenol I have to show. Remember, what do we do? From phenol, I did a reaction called bromination reaction. So what clue should I remember? I have to remember, whenever it is bromination, if I have my aqueous bromine or bromine water, I'm going to get 2,4,6 products. If I have bromine in carbon disulfide, I get either ortho product as well as para product. I've done already in the bromination reaction. So what did we get? We got 2,4,6 tribromo product. So what do I require? I require bromine, okay, bromine water, or if I say, you can also write aqueous medium. How many bromines did I take? Yes, I took 3 bromines. So what do I get? I get 3 to the 6 means HBr extra. HBr is again out because you have utilized this H here. So 3 to the 6, 3 bromines have joined here, and the leftover 3 bromines with these 3 hydrogens is HBr. So what is the reagent here? So aqueous bromine will give me 2,4,6 product. Yeah, I've already done one reasoning question for that. And your bromine in CS2 will give me ortho and para. Here they've not asked me ortho and para. They've already given me 2,4,6 tribromo. So use bromine water. So for this, this is your reagent CrO3 in the presence of pyridine, or you can also use PCC. Yeah, for this particular thing, specifically writing sodium borohydride. Yes, for this aqueous medium, or you can just write bromine water. This is your